Hi all, today we are going to discuss about parallel operation of three-phase transformers of group number 3 and group number 4. So before proceeding to this, let us see the basics briefly that is required. These basics are already discussed in our previous class. So same thing I am briefly discussing in 1-2 minutes, then we will go for group 3 and group 4 transformers. So generally if in a transformer the primary side, or generally it is not represented by primary and secondary, it is represented by the high voltage and the low voltage. We know the high voltage phasor will be longer than that of the low voltage phasor. Generally the high voltage phasor is represented by the minutes dialed in your clock, and the low voltage phasor or the low voltage side is represented by the hours dial. So with respect to the high voltage, because high voltage or the high voltage is taken as the reference, so with respect to this high voltage, how much the low voltage is lagging or leading, based on that it is represented by different connections. So if you are taking a clock, if you are taking this as 12 o'clock, so this will be 6, this will be 3, and this will be 9, or otherwise it is having total 12 digits, because hours dial can switch to total 12 hours. So total angle is 360 degrees divided by the 12, that gives 30 degrees, 30 degrees phase shift. So let us take for example, I am taking the primary, this is my primary phasor, and secondary phasor or the low voltage phasor is here. That means the high voltage phasor is at 12 and the low voltage phasor is at number 1. So what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this one is the low voltage phasor is lagging behind the high voltage phasor by 30 degrees, because in counterclockwise direction we take as a leading. So this connection is called as minus 30 degrees connection, or the connection number 1, that means it is represented by secondary side, depending on what is the connection. So this is that minus 30 degrees connection, this is called as phasor group number 3. So the group number 3, the transformers that is used for doing this will be, either we can use the delta, primary side is delta, secondary side is represented by a small letter, that is a DY1, or using star delta transformer also we can get it, that is called as YD11, and same way we can get using star by zigzag star transformer connection, this is called as YZ1. So using these connections I can get my minus 30 degrees connection or group 3. Similarly, if your low voltage phasor, so if you are taking your high voltage phasor is this one, your low voltage phasor is leading your high voltage phasor by 30 degrees. So automatically this will come at 11. So this is called as plus 30 degrees connection or 11 connection. So this is called as phasor group number 4. Again in group number 4, this is possible using delta star connection. So it is 11. 11 represent it is plus 30 degrees. So similar way, star delta transformer also this is possible. So this is one, sorry, here. Okay. So similar way, using star by zigzag star transformer also we can get this one. So using the same transformers, either we can get one connection or 11 connection, because there can be plus or minus 30 degrees phase displacement between the primary and the secondary. So let us try to see the connections of their respective things. So here today I am only discussing about star delta and delta star transformer connections, and zigzag transformer connection explanation takes more time. If you want the details, you can refer to lecture number 31. There I have explained how the zigzag star transformer can be used to change the connections from the group number 3 to group number 4. So there you can see in detail, because now if I discuss that, the time will increase drastically. So now I am starting with the delta star transformer connection. That means primary side is delta and secondary side is star connection. So let us take for example, I am taking my three windings are there. These are my three windings, or these three windings I can represent like this. These are my three primary windings. Let us assume these are my secondary windings. Okay, and primary winding terminals I am keeping by the capital letters. Let us take it as A1, A2. And phase B winding B1, B2, and phase C winding will be C1, C2. I am taking the dot notation. This indicates if your supply is given or current is entering A2 here, and it will be positive at the dot in the secondary side. So this I am naming as A2, A1, B2, B1, and this is C2, C1. So now let us take the phases. So phase I am taking as like this. This is phase A. This is phase B. Let us take it as phase C. And phase A, I am taking the connection like this. So this is my value of A2, A1. So similarly, after A comes, because we have to always take the phase sequence A, B, C. So then comes the B here. So this becomes B1, P2, then comes C. So this becomes C1 and C2. So these are the connections that is given. The C2 is connected to phase C, and B2 is connected to phase B, and A2 is connected to phase A. Or otherwise, I am just making the connections here. A2 is connected to B1, and B2 is connected to C1, and C2 is connected to A1. So, and the input is given to A2, B2, C2. Getting it? So, now, if you are representing this as a phasor diagram, so phasor form, I can represent as a parallel lines to these things. So, I can represent like this. This is my phasor A, this is my phasor B, and this is my phasor C. So, phasor A, so this is A2, this is for phase A. Similarly, this is for phase B, so this is B2, and this is for phase C, this is C2. This is the primary side phasor. So, let us try to see what will happen depending on how you make the connections in the secondary side. Again, secondary side also, it should be drawn parallel to these things, and always we should get the phase sequence as ABC, same phase sequence should come. So, let us start with phasor A. So, phasor A, I am drawing the parallel. So, this is small a2 because it is in the secondary side. This is phasor A. So, then comes phasor B. So, phasor B I am drawing here. So, this phasor B, if I draw parallel to this B, so this becomes B2. This is my phasor B. And parallel to C I am drawing here. So, this becomes C2. This is phasor C. Getting it? So, again you can see I am following the phase sequence ABC. So, now let us try to compare what is the phase displacement between these two. That means here what I have done? I have combined A1, B1, C1 together, taken the output from A2, B2, C2. So, in this case, if you are taking the line voltage here, because you can see in the primary side, this is my phase B and this is my phase B, C. So, if I want to calculate what is the voltage of B with respect to C, so it will be directed voltage of B with respect to voltage of C. So, this is my voltage VBC. So, same thing, let us try to calculate what is the voltage of B with respect to C here. So, this is the voltage of B with respect to C. This is my value of VBC. So, primary side is coming as the horizontal. This is my primary side reference. So, with respect to this, you can see you are getting 30 degrees. So, what is the meaning of this? With respect to this one, this VBC is lagging by 30 degrees. As the line phasor is lagging by 30 degrees when compared to the primary side. So, this is called as minus 30 degrees connection. This is called as minus 30 degrees connection, or this is also called as a dy. Minus 30 degrees means 1. This is called as dy 1 connection. Getting it? This is called as dy 1 connection. So, now let us assume I want to convert this dy 1 connection to dy 11 connection so that I can operate in parallel with the transformer of group number 4 or transformer of the other group. That means transformer of group number 4, because this belongs to group number 3. So, for this what I can do, you can see the phasor, this is the value of VBC. This is lagging by 30 degrees. So, I am just trying to represent this here. This is my value of my reference. With respect to the reference, this is my value. It is lagging by 30 degrees. This is my original value. So, the new value, I want that the same phasor should shift here. This is my new value. This is my old value. This is my new value. It should lead by 30 degrees. So, how to convert this phasor to this phasor? So, in the last class, we have discussed how to convert group number 1 to group number 2. So, in order to convert from group number 1 to group number 2, we have reversed the secondary side terminals. That means secondary side respect to phase terminals, when they are reversed, we have seen it is shifted by 180 degrees. That means it is shifted by 180 degrees. That means whatever is old, if I reverse the terminals, it will be shifted here. So, this is shifted by 180 degrees. So, this total is 180 degrees, but actually I want only 60 degree shifting. So, what should I do? I have to shift in this positive direction or in this direction by 120 degrees. That means I can reverse the terminals of the secondary. That is the first thing I will follow. Along with that, I have to change, shift the phasor by 120 degrees. How to get this? In order to shift the phasor by 120 degrees, we can cyclically change the phase sequence of my input. We have to cyclically change the phase sequence of my input. So, let us see how to get this one. How to get this one. So, again, I am going back to delta and star connection. So, delta star I am drawing. So, the initial one. So, I am just directly drawing the phasor. So, this is my value of A2 and this is my value of B2. and this is my value of C2. Getting it? So these are the three connections. So, and accordingly we got my secondary as like this. So this is my value of A2, B2 and C2. So how the connections are made? This A2 is taken as phase number A, B2 I am taking as phase number B, C2 is connected to phase C. That means this is connected to A and this is connected to B and this is connected to C. You can see here we have to follow the phase sequence A, B, C. So in the secondary side also I have followed the phase sequence A, B, C. Agree with me? So now coming to this one, I am cyclically shifting it by the one phase. So when I shift by one phase, that means A will occupy the position of B, B will occupy the position of C, C will occupy the position of A. That means they are shifted by one shifting. So shifting means I am taking the same windings. So please try to understand, because if you understand this, most of the problem will solve. So this is one, this is the second one, this is the third one. This A2, B2, C2 I am not changing. This is A2, this is my terminal B2, this is my terminal C2. Getting it? So now this A is shifted here, then B is shifted upwards and C is shifted upwards. You can see the position number B is now shifted here and position number C is now shifted here and position number A is shifted here. So when you shift the things like this, so let us see what is going to happen. So secondary side, accordingly the shift, the diagram will be same. So I am drawing the diagram. So now this is A2, this is B2 and this is C2. Agree with me? So now as C is connected to A2, so same C will come at A2. That means we can tell that this is my phase C, because the phase C is applied here. So phase A is applied here and phase, this is connected to B, right? So phase B is applied here. Initially actually this is A, this is B, this is C. The C2, A2, B2 are the terminal numbers, forget about them. So now they are changed cyclically, A, B, C. So this becomes A2 is connect, will become your small c. Now B2, what will be the B2? Now B2 is connected, will become now phase A. So this becomes phase A. Now C2 becomes, what is the value of C2? C2 becomes phase B. So this becomes phase B. Okay, now this phase sequence came. So let us see what is the shift that came in this one. So if you observe here, the voltage of B with respect to C, here we got it like this. This is voltage of B with respect to C. So now here voltage of B with respect to C, now this becomes phase B and this becomes phase C. So voltage of B with respect to C, this is voltage of B with respect to C. So if you observe it, so when with respect to this phasor, now this is shifted by 120 degrees. So this is shifted by 120 degrees. That means initially this is my value of VBC old. Just by changing the sequence, so this will be shifted by 120 degrees in the clockwise direction. That means this will be shifted by 120 degrees in the clockwise direction. So this is what happened. This is my VBC. So here we have concluded that if you are shifting it cyclically in the forward direction, so this is shifting by 120 degrees. So it is shifted by 120 degrees. So once this is shifted by 120 degrees, if you reverse the phases, that means if you reverse the terminals, I have told you that it will automatically reverse the voltage by 180 degrees. So this will be VBC new dash. That means when you reverse the terminals. So when you reverse the terminals, what happens? This is shifted back by 180 degrees. So this angle will become equal to 60 degrees. This is a simple technique I am following. That means what I am doing, instead of taking from C2, I will take from C1, because this value is C1, this value is B1, this value is A1. Just instead of that, reverse the terminals. Here I am sure some of you may be having some confusion. In order to clarify the confusion, please refer to lecture number 31. So before coming to this lecture, so the concept of these voltage inductions and other things will be completely clear to you. So here I am assuming that you have the basic knowledge. So I am directly discussing these things. So now I am reversing the terminals. So what I am doing? So this C1 I am taking as my output. So this is connected to B. So now this B2, instead of B2, I want to take from B1. So I am taking it opposite to this one. 180 degrees opposite to this one. So B1 will be here. This is B2. This is C2. So B is actually connected to phase A. So this you connect to phase A. So similarly C also I am reversing. This is my value of C2. So see, this is A2, right? A2 and this is A1. So this is connected to phase C. So now you see the phase difference or the VBC. So VBC will be like this. This is my value of VBC. So with respect to my reference value, VBC now converted as 30 degrees. So if you want to convert a transformer of group number 1 to group number 11, so what thing you have to do? There are two things you have to do. One thing is, let us note down the steps, then we will proceed further. So first thing is, group 3 to group 4, that means minus 30 degrees to plus 30 degrees, what should I do? So shift the phase, by 1. So that means initially if it is ABC, so now it will be shifted to, because as it is shifted by 1, so this becomes A will shift to B, B will shift to C, and C will shift to A. So this C comes to A will shift to B. So this will become C, A, B. In this way you have to shift it, C, A, B. So this is the first one. So after this you have to do is, so reverse the output terminals of each phase. So with this, what is happening? By doing the first activity, so the angle is shifted by 120 degrees. By doing the second activity, so it is shifted back by 180 degrees. So what is the resultant of this? The result of this is, so first one is shifting by 120 degrees, second one by 180 degrees. So the result will be, this will be shifted by 60 degrees when compared to the old one. So as there is a shifted 60 degrees phase shift, this minus 30 degrees depends becomes plus 30 degrees conversion. Getting it? So if you want to convert from minus 30 degrees to plus 30 degrees, so what you have to do? Shift the sequence in the clockwise direction, then after that reverse the terminals. So let us take the example of plus 30 degrees connection, and I want to convert to the minus 30 degrees connection. That means I am taking plus 30 degrees connection, I want to convert to minus 30 degrees connection. So let us take an example again. I am taking DY11 connection. So then we will try to shift it, and let us see what is going to happen. So DY11 connection I am drawing again. So this is my DY11 connection. Let us assume I am taking this as A2, this is phase A. This is my B2, this is phase B. And this is phase C, and this is my value of C2. So this is connected to phase C, and this is connected to phase A, and this B2 is connected to phase B. And now if you draw the parallel lines to this to follow the ABC phase sequence, so this A2 will come here. Similarly, B will be parallel to B, B2 will come here. C will be parallel to C, so C2 will come here. So the output are taken like this, A2, B2 and C2. Getting it? So this is A, B and C. So now the shift between primary and secondary, you can see here again, this is my value of VBC, voltage of B with respect to phase C. Now see voltage of B with respect to C, this is VBC. So with respect to the reference, this is shifted by 30 degrees. So actually this is 30 degrees connection, or this is nothing but DY11 connection. So now I want to convert this connection to DY1 connection. DY1 connection. So let us see what is the logic I have to follow to the inverse one. So the inverse one, actually I have, this is my plus 30 degrees. So this is the old one. So new one, I want to shift to this new one. So that means this should be shifted by 60 degrees in this direction. How to shift by 60 degrees? We know that if you are reversing the terminals, it will shift by 180 degrees. And if you are changing the cyclical in such a way, it will shift by 120 degrees. So let us see, if I am reversing my terminal, that means old one, if I reverse only the secondary terminals, this will become, this is a new one. So this is shifted by 180 degrees. So from this, how much is this? This shift will be 120 degrees. Agree with me? So then automatically new one will come. So what should I do? I have to reverse the secondary terminals and cyclically shift the sequence. In which direction we have to change? We have to change in the counterclockwise direction. So counterclockwise direction in both sides, cyclically shift by counterclockwise direction in both sides, because we have to shift in this direction, right? So now let us try to do this one. So what I am doing, I am cyclically shifting these components. So for that, again I am going to the next diagram so that this will be more clear to you. So now this is my initial value. So this is my value of A2, this is my value of B2, this is phase A, this is my value of A2, sorry. So this is my phase C, so this is my value of C2. So this is initially connected like this. So this is my value of A, this is my value of B, phase C, and secondary side also I am just drawing to make this easy. So B2, this is my value of C2, this is my value of A2. So let us try to change the sequence in counterclockwise direction and then let us see what will happen so that you will get some idea. So this one I am taking the connections. So this is my value of A2. This is my node number B2 is here, right? This is my node B2 and this is my node C2. So now this sequence should be changed cyclically in counterclockwise direction. Counterclockwise direction means that A will shift here, that C will shift here and B will shift here. So that means wherever A is there, this A phase is now shifted to here, then this B phase is shifted here, C phase is shifted by 1. This is the C phases. So now if you are taking the secondary side phasors, so again same thing, this is my node B, node A2 and this is my node C2. So previously this is phase B, this is phase C, this is phase A. So now they are cyclically shifted by 1. That means this becomes phase A. So A is shifted here. So because see, A is shifted here, then C is shifted here and then B is shifted here. That means this will be my taken as my terminal B, this will be taken as terminal C, this will be taken as terminal A. So now see the voltage difference between the primary and secondary or reference to the primary. So now the phasor will be like this. This is my value of VBC. So previously this is my value of VBC old, this is my value of VBC new. So you can see here this VBC old, it is shifted by 120 degrees, but actually I want my new value here. So how to convert this one? Reverse the terminals in the secondary side. So what I am doing, instead of taking from B2, I take from B1. So I am drawing it here. This is my value of B1, B2. Getting it? So now reverse the terminals. So this will become, sorry, this will become C2 and C1. And similarly, this B is changed. So this will be A2 and A1. So A1 is connected to now B phase, sorry. A1 is connected to B phase. Now C1 is connected to A phase and B1 is connected to C phase. So this way I am reversing. So now you can see here what is the voltage of VBC. So this is my value of VBC. So now you can see here it is shifted by 30 degrees or total the phase shift came. So this is converted to DY and it is shifted. So DY1 connection. So DY11 connection is now shifted to DY1 connection. So how to convert from group 4 to group 3? Using this I can do. So same thing you can repeat for the case of star connection also. So let us take the case of star by delta transformer and see how this can be done. So I am taking star by delta connection. So star delta connection, let us take it as A2, B2 and C2. A1, B1, C1 are connected together. So the value of VBC is like this. So if I am taking the delta, A colon delta, let us convert YD11 to YD1. That means to convert YD11, so if you are combining them, you will get like this. I am directly writing this one. So B2 and this is my value of C2 and this is my value of A2. This is my value of A2. So this will be connected to phase A. This is phase B and this is phase C. So now if you take the angle, this is my value of VBC. So VBC, you can see it is actually leading by 30 degrees. So I want it should shift in this direction by 60 degrees. It should shift in this direction by 60 degrees. So if you reverse the terminals, it will shift by 180 degrees, then shift in the counterclockwise. So to achieve this, what should I do? I have to rotate in this direction by 120 degrees and then rotate in this direction by 180 degrees. So how to get this 180 degrees? Shift the sequence ABC in this order, because we know the initially the order is ABC. So when you shift it, so this A will shift to C position, C will shift to B like this. So this will become B, C, A. This is my new order. In this sequence, you have to give the inputs. And then the second one, what you have to do, cyclically shift, you have to shift on both primary as well as the secondary. Please remember this one. After that, reverse the terminals of the secondary side. When you reverse the terminals of the secondary side, it will come back to your normal vector or plus 60 degrees vector. So let us see how can I do that one. So again, I am drawing the things. This is my value of A2. This is my value of B2. This is my value of C2. So this is actually connected to A. This is connected to B. This is connected to C. So secondary side, what is happening? So this is my value of A2. This is my value of B2. And this is my value of C2. This is connected to C. This is connected to B. And this is connected to getting it. So now what I told you, cyclically shift in the counterclockwise direction. So shift like this by 120 degrees. So I am drawing the new phasor. So again, same thing. So primary side, I am taking this one. So this will be A2, B2, C2. So now they are cyclically shifted. So A shifts here and this C shifts here and B shifts here, cyclically shifted by 120 degrees. So getting this one. So now which phase is applied here? B is applied here, C is applied here, and A is applied here. So now the secondary side, again I am drawing the same thing. Now let us see how the secondary side is shifted. So as this is connected to B, this will be B, this will be now B. So this is connected to C and this is connected to C is connected to A. So what is the terminal here? This is A2. This is B2 and this is my shift because of the respective shifting. So now see the phasor, how much it is shifted. So this is my value of VBC. So previously this is my value of VBC. It is shifted by 120 degrees. It is shifted by 120 degrees. So this is the B, sorry, I have reversed the terminals, right? This is my value of VBC. It is shifted by 120 degrees. So after that, in order to get this, I have to reverse the terminals in the secondary side. So secondary side, instead of taking the output from A2, I will take my output from A1. So that's why I am just keeping it in the second side. This is my A2, this is my A1. So this is connected to phase B. So now reverse this one. So reversing this one means I am drawing here. So this is my value of B2, B1. So now this is connected to phase C. And now reversing this second, the last one. So last one I am reversing here. So this is my value of C2. Instead of C2, I am taking from C1. This will be connected to phase A. So this is phase A, B and C. So you have to join B1 with C1, C2 with A2 and B2 with A1. So this is the sequence. So now see the phase difference between B and C. So this is my value of VBC. So now you can see with respect to the reference, you got the 30 degrees phase shift. So this is converted to YD1 connection. So this is my YD11 connection is shifted to YD1 connection. So in this way, you can reverse it. So I am just making the summary. If you want to convert from group 3 to group 4, so what you have to do? Cyclically shift by 120 degrees in this direction, then shift it by 180 degrees. Shift it by 180 degrees. So if you are doing that, it will be converted from group number 3 to group number 4. That means it will convert from minus 30 degrees to plus 30 degrees. So let us take the opposite. If you want to convert from group number 4 to group number 3. So if you want to convert from group number 4 to group number 3, so shift in this direction by 120 degrees, because I want to convert from plus 30 degrees to minus 30 degrees. So shift by 120 degrees, that means cyclically shift the phases, then reverse the terminals in any one side. So this will be shifted by 180 degrees. So net result will be there is a shift by, so this is my net effect. Getting it? So if you want to convert from minus 30 degrees, minus 30 degrees means vector is initially here, I have to convert to here. So I have to shift in this direction. So that's why shift it cyclically by 120 degrees on both primary and secondary, then reverse the terminals of the secondary. So in that case you will get it. I hope how to convert from group number 3 to group number 4 or group number 4 to group number 3 is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.